there was an undercurrent in the revolution which was very much about freeing Egypt from the external influence of various actors, including the U.S. So I think that's very important to understand, because right now being pro-revolution in Egypt is tied to being as far away as possible from U.S. influence. Now, this leads us to a situation where everyone's accusing everyone else of foreign funding, of being American stooges. So you have this very odd situation now where even liberals, who you'd think would be more sympathetic to the U.S., are accusing the Muslim Brotherhood of being American stooges. So I actually, we met with the, I won't say who, but a top Egyptian official in January, and I thought he was joking at first, but he essentially said that he believes that the U.S. has this grand master plan to install the Muslim Brotherhood and ultra-conservative Salafis into government. So I thought he was just kind of messing around with us, so we pushed him a little bit more, and he was serious. He's like, you know, we have evidence this is true, it's happening as we speak, and this is a new narrative that you hear a lot more in Egypt, that the Muslim Brotherhood in the U.S. are now in cahoots and are working together. Now, the Brotherhood accuses the U.S. of backing liberals or backing the SCAF. So every, you know, the U.S. is backing whoever your opponent is. That's essentially how it works in Egypt now. And I actually had a personal experience with this kind of culture of xenophobia or whatever you want to call it. I wrote about this elsewhere, but during the elections in November, my cab driver actually attempted a citizen's arrest on me and essentially dragged me into the police station, and I was detained briefly. Why? As he later told me afterwards, after he felt bad, he thought that I was, believe it or not, an Israeli spy who had learned to speak Arabic, and my Arabic is slightly accented, so he was very suspicious, like, where is this guy actually from? And I've been conducting research in Egypt from the Mubarak regime on. I never feared for my safety under Mubarak, but now foreigners are going to Egypt, journalists are going to Egypt, and they're getting beaten, they're getting surrounded by crowds. So that's the kind of context that we find ourselves in now. Now, moving on, well, this is important because I think it makes the task of reorienting U.S. policy to Egypt much more difficult because of the toxic nature of American influence, but I think it also makes it more urgent. Something has gone very much wrong now, and I think it's time for us as Americans to kind of step back and reassess and rethink what our relationship with the Egyptian government, but also the Egyptian people, should be.